Good afternoon, GCPC family. Today is Monday, and I'm coming to you from Shaker Heights, Ohio. I'm showing you part of my front yard where the for sale sign says pending. And we have spent the better half of today dealing with leaves. So many leaves. Look at that tree. The tree is naked, and the leaves are gone. But it made me think a lot about when things change. And the sign in the front of my house has been there for about a week and a half now, saying pending. Waiting is hard. We waited last week for election results, and many of us are actually feeling relief in our whole bodies because we were embodying so much fear and concern about the state of our nation and are feeling some relief. And I'm realizing the relief I feel when I get to come to worship with you all and think about the future. And then I look at these leaves, and this morning I was thinking, this is the last thing I want to do, is deal with the leaves. But then I realized that part of our leaving is to make things look good, to still do the things that make us us, and that even while things are pending, we have work to do. Our stated clerk and a dear friend of mine, Reverend J. Herbert Nelson, very early on in our relationship, I heard him preach where he talked about how when there's three ways that people are in general, that there's seasons that people are, and they're either going through something difficult, they're coming out of something difficult, or they're about to go back into something difficult. And I don't know where we are in the midst of all of that. But I do know that all of us are carrying something with us and something that's pending, something that we need to partner with God to get through, to move on to. And I just want to encourage you that this time where we're waiting for the transition of power to happen and all of the things that may or may not happen as a result of that, thinking about the ways we feel relieved but also have concerns and need to keep our leaders accountable for either promises they made or things that we don't agree still with them. If it's family, that we are anticipating family holidays, trying to negotiate what it looks like in a COVID world to have family gatherings, to find new ways to connect to one another. Also to give yourself permission to not spend as much time with people, which always feels maybe a little icky or selfish, but I do think that in the waiting, sometimes the best thing we can do is take a breath, to find ways to gather ourselves, to do the work that needs to be done around our houses, but also to remember the work that needs to be done inside of you. During the faith sharing this week, we talked about how puppies were a really good way to remind us to ask for the things that we need. And I just want to encourage you to ask for what you need, to think about in this waiting time and the transition of seasons when leaves are falling and it gets darker earlier and the sun comes out and you're trying to figure out what day it is. Talk to the people around you. Tell them what you need. Maybe it's friends who are far away and tell them what you need, that you need to talk to them. And then have them share with you what they might need. I am so excited to be in community with you all. I continually pray for you and do ask that you'll pray for me. So many of you I know have been praying for our transition, and I do think that is such a huge part of why things really are going smoothly. They do feel a little chaotic, but it's not because things aren't happening. Things are happening and kind of quicker than I thought, but I think that's confirmation of where we need to be right now and the excitement that we have for being in the community and to be shoulder to shoulder with you, even if it's virtually. I think it's wonderful that we heard our president-elect speak of so many positive things and the passage from Isaiah that he recalled from a hymn, I think is such a great one for us to hold up and to think about during this time of changing seasons and transitioning when things are pending. So let me read that to you now. But they who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with eagle's wings. They shall run and not grow weary. They shall walk and not grow faint. We still have so much work to do together, but I am confident that if we are clear about our intentions, if we can let those around us know what we need and respond to the needs around us, God will partner with us, move us forward, move us from pending to the next thing and then the next thing. Friends, I pray that your week is starting off strong, and if it's not, take a deep breath. Remember the hope we have in our partnership with God and our community with one another. Have a great week.